Well, one of the questions that we had was, what exactly is in the walls of this home? When we looked, we discovered a high quality reflective house wrap. And while it was really good quality, it was not very well installed. It was not fixed to the bottom of the walls at all, so it was just flapping in the breeze and lapped in the middle, but only came to 2.4 meter height. And most of this house has 2.7 meter ceilings. So the top 300 millimeters of the walls were actually just open to the elements. In effect, the reflective nature of the wrap became completely pointless because there was absolutely no chance of a still air. So what to do about it? What we decided to do was actually remove plasterboard, treat the walls, and then put the plasterboard back on. And how did we do that? Well, we cut the plasterboard about 100 millimeters in from the corners of a room, 100 millimeters in from architraves and skirts and cornice, so that we didn't have to disturb those. Took the plasterboard off, and then we got material like this, a retro shield, and cut it into sections that would fit into a stud noggin space, put it in, made little hospital corners in there, and stapled it in all the way around. So the idea is we made a still airspace. Next, we glued some battens to it. The purpose of that was to hold the bulk material off the reflective surface, and you can see that here. And then we put the polyester bat in like that and put on new plasterboard and jointed it. Of course, jointing, quite a skilled thing to do, is to make it so that you can't see the joins. And then of course you have to redecorate. But that's what we did. It made a massive difference, of course. And we left this little piece here just so that we could show people actually what we did in the walls.